seconds, making the car turn left. Some of these drivers are getting Ross Chastain was wound up on the high side coming out of turn number two, past a couple. He's going for more up here in turn four. We talked to Ross Chastain before the race, and he talked about how he was so uncomfortable last year about spun out qualifying. As you see him go to the top side again and not have to lift off the throttle, he's obviously told us that we had a lot. He put a lot of handling into his car based on how uncomfortable he was last year. Now you start to see him be able to utilize that in that third lane.
Yeah, the number one thing he told us pre-race was, I wanted all the handling I could get. Told my crew chief, forget the speed. We need handling if you want me to win this race.
That's going to kick off the pit cycle as we go through this segment of the race.
So 45 miles an hour here on the actual pit road.
Fuel only for Ryan Blaney, so that's just a time thing. They don't want to stay on pit road any longer than they have to, because you're already going to give up a lap and a half just coming to pit road. You have to do everything you can to just get right back off of pit road.
Same with Logano, and they'll come out together. Not quite as critical as it is at Daytona, but still. Now their teammate, Austin Cindric, he is hunting the lead off turn number two. Shoots by Brad Keselowski in the second. Now Cindric against Larson. And Larson drops to the bottom to hold the lead.
A really tight side draft. Keselowski and Chastain off of four. They maybe brushed a little bit there. Chastain's been watching him for the last few laps. Starting to lose a nose bat. Looks like Cindric to pit road here. Very hard to come on the pit road that fast and then down. There's markers to aid you, visuals, Kevin, but that straight-on shot like that, that's very tricky to gauge your depth perception.
30 to go in stage two, which has been all green flags so far.
You see Kyle Larson pull down right there. He thought that Austin Cindric was shooting down to try to pass him, and he went down there to block him, and Austin Cindric kept coming up here road. Now you see a huge run from the one and the six, and Brad Keselowski up on the outside of Kyle Larson.
It takes me back to the way they used to be, the good old days of racing. Like, these guys and their options, right? Brad Keselowski pre-race told us, this is the plan. We have drag, we have downforce in this car. I don't have the speed to take off with these boys, but it should come to me. As this race progresses, it should come to me on a long run, and that is exactly what we're seeing.
He's coming to you in the pits.
Chastain,
somebody had
I think he got down to the wrong pit road speed right there. 90 mile an hour, and he walked to 45. That was almost a big wreck.
Well, that's what we talk about, Clint. The driver and the spotter have a responsibility to change that up, and we go from 45 under caution to 90 under green, and I think Brad got that wrong, like you said.
Scenarios.
Now, also, we talked about the radius of that apron. And if you run the inside, you're really at a different speed than if you run the outside, because NASCAR measures time over distance. Could each of those drivers have a different number in mind?
No, but when they do make a mistake like that in front of you and you're down low, that's where it's problematic.
Oh, crash! William Byron and Michael McDowell have crashed on the apron.
You're not going up again.
No caution
yet. They're not going to want to throw it because of the scenario that it would unfold. They're going to keep it green.
Yes, we stay green. Not sure how much damage was done there.
Back to my point, though. Say they stack up on the outside of you and you're forced down. Your pit road speed and everything you've practiced is off of that outside line around there. If you're forced to the bottom, you're merely guessing on your speed, Kevin.
And you would typically just slow safe. Big damage for McDowell there on the right front as he